Okay, I'm kidding. Nobody's stealing anything today. However, what we're doing today is figuring out what NordVPN and CCTV cameras have in common. And the answer is pretty simple. They both increase your security. But instead of blowing hundreds of dollars on the equipment, we'd rather stay on the budget-friendly side of things. And that's where these two old phones come into play. There's a good chance that you've got a backup phone, or a couple of them, gathering dust in a desk drawer. And unless the phone is really old, and we're talking about devices running operating systems older than iOS 14.2 or Android 7, you're just a charging brick and a cable away from having your own security camera system. The market is full of out-of-the-box solutions for CCTV cameras. However, there's a couple of buts. A lot of the out-of-the-box offers come with subscription fee. On top of that, the cost of this kind of IP camera is quite high to begin with. Then, depending on what kind of brand you choose to go with, the recordings may be stored on a remote server, which is a possibility of a security risk. With our approach, there are no subscription fees, the cost, depending on what's hiding in your desk drawers, is minimal if not none, and we're keeping everything local and secure. And most of the time, you're going to access these security cameras from outside of your home network. Usually, that can be achieved with the use of either port forwarding or using third-party cloud service providers. Luckily, we can just set up NordVPN Meshnet on our phones to access the camera streams remotely. If you're planning to put the phone in a remote location without a Wi-Fi connection, be sure to grab a SIM card and check if there's any power outlet to plug in a phone charger. I'm going to start with our Android phone. We've got the NordVPN and security cameras apps already installed on it. We will be using an app called IP Webcam, but any other app that turns your Android device into an IP camera should work too. If you need step-by-step instructions, be sure to check out the video descriptions for the links to our documentation. It's crucial to stay on the safe side of things, and that's why we're going to enable authorization within our IP webcam, because by default, the app doesn't require credentials to access the stream. We don't want anyone to have unauthorized access to the camera. Next, we'll set up recording storage directory. This is especially important if your Android device is equipped with an external SD card. Head over to the video preferences section and select the directory you want the videos to be saved to. Once everything is ready, we'll start the IP webcam server through the three dots menu in the top right corner. Next, let's make sure our meshnet is up and running. I've already created an account and logged into it on the phone. Now, we need a way to access the IP webcam remotely. You can do that with another phone, tablet, laptop, or pretty much any other device that can run meshnet and a web browser. And I'm going to use my laptop for the convenience. First, we'll have to find the phone's meshnet Nord name. With that, we can open up a web browser and paste the address into it. Make sure to add the correct port at the end of the IP. And by default, that's going to be 8080. We're going to use the same credentials we set up on the phone while we were setting up the app to log in here. Next, in the video render section, we'll choose browser, as this allows us to monitor the camera in real time. And last, but not least, let's start the recording. Once the recording has been started, you will see the name of the file it's currently being saved to. You can also check all other recorded videos in the video archive section of the web UI. And all that's left is to hook up the phone to a charging brick and set it up on a shelf somewhere in your home. You can also grab a cheap tripod so that you can point the phone exactly where you want to. And for those of you who found an old iPhone in your desk drawer, there's also a solution. While it isn't as robust as the one for Android devices, it still allows you to watch the camera feed in real time. For our webcam streaming, we're using the Live Reporter app, which at the time of the recording this video is free. But if you can find any other app that can support streaming over RTSP, you should be good to go too. RTSP stands for Real-Time Streaming Protocol and allows sending video as well as audio over the internet. Since we still want to be able to access the stream remotely while we're not at home, we'll need the NordVPN app too. I will be using VLC on my laptop to open the RTSP stream, but any other app that supports RTSP streams will work too. Then, all we need to do is open up the Live Reporter app and set up the authorization. Hit the wrench and the hammer icon in the bottom right corner of the screen, head over to the Network tab and put in your credentials. Next, on my computer, I'm gonna connect to the stream using VLC. I'm gonna head to File, then Open Network. Within that menu, I'm gonna copy and paste the iPhone's meshnet IP address and add RTSP:// in front of it. Then I'm gonna hit open, and yeah, there you go. The iPhone app is limited when it comes to features, but it's still a great way to check up on your pets or kids whenever you're away or at work. The main downside is having to keep the screen always on, so make sure that you set the screen brightness as low as possible and use a phone that you don't really need anymore. Same as with the Android device. Remember to plug in the charger and perhaps grab a tripod to place the phone somewhere high so you can get the most out of it. All right, that's it for the video. If you have any questions or suggestions, be sure to leave them in the comments below. And as always, if you liked the video, like and subscribe to our channels for more videos.